Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today in video 8, we are going to continue with the topic of preparation of aldehyde and ketone from hydrocarbon. Now, from hydrocarbon, when we say, this is given on page 361 and 362. Right? Now, when we talk about from hydrocarbon, there is one technique, we call it as ozonolysis. Right? Now, what is ozonolysis? When we say, we use ozone and zinc dust and water. Means first we react with O3, we will get a complex, and that complex is treated with what we call, that is an intermediate, what we call, right? And that intermediate is treated with zinc dust and water, and we get the required product. But there are certain ways. Sometimes when you do ozonolysis, you get aldehyde. In some cases you get ketone. In some cases you get both aldehyde and ketone, that is a mixture of product. Now that depends on what type of alkenes you are using. Okay, so that we are going to discuss. Okay, so three types what I am going to discuss, that when we get aldehyde by ozonolysis, when we get ketone, and when we get a mixture of aldehyde and ketone, that I am going to explain through an example. Okay, so what we say here, from hydrocarbon, that is by ozonolysis of alkene, what we say. Okay, so in this case, suppose ozonolysis is done first reacting it with the O3 and then reacting it with the zinc, Zn, and water, zinc dust. Zinc dust is used as a catalyst here, and water. So in this case, when we say the first reaction I write here, and I use one alkene here. Now, on that alkene is a simple, you can see here, Ca3, CH2, CH, double bond CH2, right? Now, always remember, there is one technique in ozonolysis, that is, the double bond carbon you need to remember, what we say, yeah? The double bond carbon. These are the double bond carbon, what you have to remember. Now, what happens when you treat it with the O3, this double bond carbon, I will write like this, Ca3, CH2, then C, and H I will write separate of this. Then that double bond I will break, and what will happen in this case, here I will write oxygen, here again carbon, here oxygen, and this carbon, this terminal carbon is this, what we say. And this here two hydrogen groups are there, so that I will write like this separately, what we say. Understood? So this CH2, this H2 is written in this form, and this CH3, CH2 on one side, or you can also write like this, CH3, CH2 like this, and here H. So this CH I have written here. Now, when you react this intermediate with zinc dust and water, zinc dust and water, H2O, what will happen? There is again one simple technique. You can just draw a dotted line like this. Okay? So you can break these two compounds in this. Now how to break it? See, this CH3, CH2 and CHO, I will write like this, CH3, CH2 and CHO, that is this compound what I am talking about. Okay? Plus, now this part, that is HCHO, plus what I can write, HCHO, means this is the compound what I have written. Okay? So this is one easy way to remember, I think HCHO. Like this, HCHO, it went out of your screen, so I think you can see it now. Okay, HCH, okay, so this is the way to separate these two forms. Now in this case, both what you got are aldehyde only, both are what we say here, both are aldehyde. Okay, so in this case, this is your propanol, okay, and this is your methanol. Okay, so both are aldehydes what we got. Now, suppose if you take another type of alkene, that is different types of alkene gives different product what we say. I will rub this first, otherwise no space will be there. Okay. Now, if the alkene is of this type, now suppose if you don't understand this, we can write this alkene like this also. That is Ca3C, CH double bond C, here one CH3 and here one CH3, like this you can write. So if you want to write the name, this is what 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I can write butte 2 methyl, because at second position methyl group is there, butte 2-PNA. Okay, this is your alkene what we say, but I have written it simply this way so that you can understand. Now, in this case, which one is the double bond carbon? So these two are the double bond carbon. So there we will make like a house or structure like a house. See, now how to do? I treat this O3, I will write here CH3, CH and C, this one. I am talking about this double bond. So that we will break. So here from this carbon, see, CH3, C, here H I will write, huh? This part I am talking about. Now at this carbon, I will write one here, oxygen, here again, your this part, what you say, this text, terminal carbon, here so 2CH3 I will write here, and then oxygen I will join this and form a closed chain, what you say. So here in this case, this is your intermediate. So how we make this house that you understood? Between the double bond carbons, you can write these three oxygens, what we have written. So this is the easiest way. Like this house you can make. Then you can cut off this all. Just you see that only one oxygen is left out. Now what to do? Now this part. See, CH3CHO. So I can write here, that is with zinc dust and water when you treat. Or directly also you can write like this, ZN and H2O looking you can use. This is used as a catalyst. So what are the two things? What are the two products what you get? So CH3CHO. So I write here CH3CHO plus this is the next product. That is, what is this? In this case, now you cannot see hydrogen with this carbon. So actually it is formed, ketone will be formed. That is CH3C double bond O. Means this part I am talking. These two bonds I have written with oxygen. C. This here C double bond O and another one CH3. Okay? So when you see first one, this is your ethanol, understood? And this is your propanol, okay? Clear? So this gives a mixture of product in this case. So first one what we saw, we got aldehyde. In the second one what we say, we got ethanol and propanol. So mixture of product. Now the next example we will see, I will just rub this one. And third one example, you have to write down in your notebook. This is what we have done, because in your textbook these examples are not given. Okay. Now the third one, if you take alkene in this form, that is third example, I write like this, CH3 twice, then C double bond C and again CH3 twice, right? In presence of O3, ozone. When you first react with ozone, what I already informed, what you remember, what you need to remember, these two carbons you remember, okay? Now between these two carbon, you make a house-like structure with oxygen. This is the simplest way to do this reaction, okay? Now, on this carbon, how many 2CH3 groups are there? So here, CH3, here also, CH3. On this carbon, that is this one what we are talking about, 2CH3. So I write like this, CH3, CH3, right? Now, if you react this intermediate with a zinc and water, that is zinc dust and water, what I say, you can just cut it off with a dotted line like this, what we say. Clear? So, in this case, there is no hydrogen in any of this carbon. So, what you will get? Both ethone you are going to get. See, CH3, CH3, C double bond O. So, I will write here, CH3, C double bond O, again CH3, plus another one is also same. CH3C double bond O and CH3. So both are ketone in this case. Both are ketone. So this one understood? First example what we did, in that we got what? Okay? Aldehyde. Second example alkene what I took, in that you got aldehyde and ketone. And in this third example both are ketone. Okay? So in your book on in textbook page number 362 a word is given. That is, an ozonolysis is done, you will get aldehyde, ketone or a mixture of both depending on the substitution pattern of alkene. Okay, so this is the substitution pattern. Means what type of alkene you select based on that product we are going to get on ozonolysis. Now understood this part? Now in this one another is there, by hydration of alkynes. What is there? By hydration of alkyne. So that example I am going to explain next. Okay, just a minute.
Now, in preparation of aldehyde and alcohol from hydrocarbons, the second method is by hydration of alkynes, means water we are going to add. Now, in this case, when an alkyne is treated, when we say with water, okay, in presence of sulfuric acid and mercuric sulfate, sulfuric acid we know H2SO4, and mercuric sulfate means HgSO4. Understood? So you will get, that is in the first alkyne is what we say, ethyne. So when you use ethyne, you will get one product, but higher alkynes means propyne, butyne and all, you will get another product that we are going to discuss, and both example I am going to give. See, if you use ethyne means CH triple bond CH, in presence of H2SO4 and HgSO4. Clear? But in that hydration is written, so I will write here CH then plus H2O. This is what ethyne. Understood? So when you use ethyne, you will see the product what you are going to get, temperature also you can write it down, it is 343 Kelvin. This, don't forget this temperature. So when you use this ethyne, acetylene, what we call it as common name, you will get an aldehyde. Aldehyde means what? CH3CH4. So this is your aldehyde what you got when you use what? Ethyne. Okay. So in this, then after that, if you use higher alkyne means what? If I use propyne, that is CH3 triple bond CH, like this, that is what? Propyne. Okay. Propyne with water in presence of H2SO4 and HgSO4 at temperature 343 Kelvin. Okay, so when you use this propyne, the product what you are going to get is ketone, that is what? CH3CO CH3, that is what? Propanone means what you are going to get here? Ketone. Okay, this is another name of propanone, that is common name is acetone. This one what you got is ethanol. Understood? Means if you use two carbon means ethyne, two carbon alkyne, you get what? Aldehyde. Clear? And three carbon and more type of alkyne you use, alkyne, you will get what? Ketone you get. What you get? Ketone. So this is an important note, you can remember. Okay, so it will be easy for you. If any questions are asked, that is complete the following reaction, at that time you can use this technique to remember. Okay, you can memorize this. That is, if already I explained you, in presence of mercuric sulfate and sulfuric acid, 343 Kelvin temperature, if you use ethyne, you will get aldehyde. Higher alkyne means more than 2 carbon if you use, you will get what? Ketone. Okay, so that is what is given in your textbook, that is by hydration of alkynes. Understood this part? There are certain things given in that, you can go through it. Okay, write down this all examples in your fair book. Now the next topic is only preparation of aldehydes, not ketone, only aldehyde, that we are going to discuss. Okay, just a minute. Okay, now the next what we are going to discuss is just the preparation of aldehyde, that is from acyl chloride. Now in this, one important type of reduction is there, that is a type Rosenmund reduction, from the name of that scientist Rosenmund. This is very important and can be asked for 2 marks. Okay, so if Rosenmund is there, another is also there for what you call preparation of ketone, like this only what we say, from acyl chloride. If both are asked, it will be of 4 marks what we say, that I will explain when I will discuss that topic. But in this case, when we say from acyl chlorides. Now, from acyl chloride means what? When we say acyl chloride or acid chloride. Understood? What is the word?
When acyl chloride, or you can also write it as acid chloride, is hydrogenated. What is the word? Hydrogenated with catalyst. Now which is that catalyst? Palladium on barium sulfate. It's being pasted with barium sulfate. What we say, it is being, that catalyst will be coated with barium sulfate. Okay, coated with barium sulfate, what we say, it will give you what? Gives aldehyde. Gives
aldehyde. Understood? Now this reaction is called Rosenmund reduction. Now why it is called reduction? Because in this case you will see hydrogenation means hydrogen is added, what we say, and oxygen is removed, like that we say. But actually there is a simple technique to remember, that is what SN chloride is your benzoyl chloride. I will write here benzoyl chloride. I can write C double bond O and Cl. This is your benzoyl chloride, right? So in that, what I am going to do, I am going to replace this chlorine. What I am going to do, we will replace this chlorine. This is the simple way to remember. But what we are going to use, we are going to use H2, then palladium on barium sulfate. So you can write either like this or put a slash like this. So hydrogenation is done with the palladium on barium sulfate. So you will see here in this case, what is being removed? See here, C double bond O, and instead of that, what I have written? Hydrogen is being added. So addition of hydrogen, what is the word? Addition of hydrogen is what we call it as, what we have studied in lower classes. That is, addition of hydrogen is reduction. What is it called? Reduction. And addition of oxygen is oxidation. So same way, we have added, what we removed? Cl. And what we added? H, from this H2. So one more hydrogen is left out, and this chlorine, what is separated, will give the byproduct HCl, like this. Understood? So this is your benzoyl chloride, and this is your benzaldehyde. What is this? Benzaldehyde. So this reduction is called Rosenmund reduction. What is this reduction called? Rosenmund reduction. Okay, now the next one. Okay, so we have discussed about this Rosenmund reduction. Why it is called reduction? Because hydrogen is added, and addition of hydrogen is reduction. This is an important class of reaction. What you have to remember, can be asked for 2 marks. Now the second one in your textbook, if you see, that is from nitriles and ester. What is the word? From nitriles and ester, that we are going to discuss. This you have to write it in your fair book. What we have seen is Rosenmund. Clear? Now, from nitriles and esters, that we are going to discuss. Okay. Now, in this case, from nitrile, the reaction is called, what we call it as Stefan reaction. What is the word? Stefan reaction. Clear? Now, Stefan reaction also, like Rosenmund, you have to remember this. It is an important class of reaction, what we are talking about. Okay? Now, in this case, Stefan reaction, you can see, nitriles I write here, a general form, RCN, nitriles are reduced to corresponding imine. Okay, in presence of SnCl2. SnCl2 is a stannous chloride. In presence of SnCl2 and HCl, it is reduced to imine. Now, what is imine? So you can write on one side for your knowledge. Imine means carbon attached with nitrogen with a double bond are called imine, not amine. It is imine, I-M-I-N-E. Okay, so when we see here, when RCN, that is nitrile, is treated with stannous chloride in presence of HCl, you will get first imine. You get what you get first? Imine. That imine can be written as RCH double bond NH. So in this case, if you see, this carbon is attached to nitrogen with a double bond, or you can write like this, RCH, I write here, double bond N and H, right? So this is the call, what way it is called, imine, what we say. Why this is called imine, that I think that part will be clear to you. Now, when it is treated, means in water, if you add acid, in this case, first RCN is converted into imine, and this imine, when we say, it's changed into aldehyde. What? RCHO. Now, if you draw the structure, you come to know RC double bond O and H, means here this double bond and this part is being removed, what we have. Okay, so this is what we call it as Stefan reaction. Huh? What is this called? Stefan reaction. Now, when we see here, what I have written that H3O plus, no? Actually, this is hydrolysis. Okay, now this is your stannous chloride. Stannous chloride. Clear? This is your nitrite. Okay, this is what we got. It's an intermediate. It is called imine. What is it called? Imine. Understood this part? So this reaction we call it as what? Which reaction we call it as Stefan reaction? Which reaction? Stefan. In which we use stannous chloride in presence of HCl. You get imine first, and from imine you can convert it into aldehyde. Understood this part? Now there is, this is the general form what I have explained. Another techniques are also there, but that I will explain in next part. Okay. Now the alternative method from nitrites to prepare aldehyde is one another technique you can see. Alternative selective reduction of nitrile by dibal. Dibal means what? Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. So when you react this nitrile, that is this one, nitrites, what we say that is CN group, with this dibal, that is dialuminium, diisobutyl aluminium hydride, you will get first imine, and imine on hydrolysis gives you what? Aldehyde. Now, general form first we will write here. You can see here, RCN when treated first with diisobutyl, what is written? So, IBU, and di means 2 I have written. Huh? And aluminium hydride, so ALH we can write like this. Understood? So, diisobutyl aluminium hydride, and then on hydrolysis, hydrolysis means H3O plus what is written, you will get what? RCHO, what we call it as. What you will get? RCHO means, if you see in this case, this nitrile group is replaced by an aldehyde, what we say. Understood? So now this was a general form. Now instead of R, if I write like this, RCH3CN in presence of aluminium isobutyl, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. First it is reacted with, and then it is reacted with H3O plus. What you get? CH3CHO. Right? So this is the general form what we call. Now, same way from esters also you can prepare what we call it as aldehyde. In that also you can use this isobutyl aluminium hydride. Okay? That we are going to see. In your book, there is one another example given with a compound, that is a nitrile or a cyanide with a double bond. But this double bond is not affected by the use of this hydride, what you say. Okay. Now, what is that example you can see in your textbook? It is given like this, CH3CH, double bond CH, then CH2, CH2 and CN. Right? So, in this case, if you see here, only the thing change is the nitrile or the cyanide group. Okay. Again, same thing I write here. You can see aluminium hydride, that is diisobutyl. Huh? It is written diisobutyl, di for 2, aluminium hydride, and then hydrolysis. Okay. So, what you will get, the CN group will change. There is no effect on the double bond, what is given here, CH. Single bond CH2, CH2, and here it will be CHO. Means the nitrile group has changed to an aldehyde group. This you can remember it very easily. Understood? So this was the thing which is given in your textbook for from nitrile. Huh? That is from nitrile. Now I am going to talk about from ester. So in ester also, only thing you have to change when we say is, instead of this cyanide, I will use now ester. So in that, the general formula, what is given for ester, you can see, I write here, RC, double bond O, dash O, and R dash. So this is the ester group, which will be replaced. This OR dash group, what we say, will be replaced by what? Aldehyde group. Or you can simply write this thing, that is RC, double bond O, and here, H, I will write. What I write here? HIO. Understood this part? Now, preparation of aldehyde from esters, when you say this is the ester group, that is RC00R is your ester group. So, in this case, this OR is being replaced with an hydrogen group. So, this form, this general form, I can write like this also, CH3C double bond O, O dash CH3 like this. Understood? So in this case, this whole group will be replaced. What we say, this whole group either R dash is taken. So R dash means will not take the methyl group; will take another group, CH to CH3. This whole group is replaced with the RC double bond O and H. Okay. So what this one you can see, this whole group is replaced by hydrogen. Instead of here, I will write here CH3.
Okay, so this is the part what we were discussing. Now, in this case, when we say the byproduct is alcohol, that is CH3, CH2 and OH, ethanol.
Ethanol, this is your ethanol. Okay, Al and OL. Okay,
so remember this thing, ethanol and ethanol. Okay, now the next part.
So this was from nitrile and ester what we have discussed. This is the ester we are talking about.
So here we will stop for this video. In the next video, we will be discussing that is preparation of aldehyde from hydrocarbon. Understood? So this one, I think it is now lengthier video than last time. So we will stop here. Next time we will continue. Okay. Thank you very much.